Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs on Protection of RTD Measurement Systems. In the last several videos, we covered the protection of a delta-sigma converter used in RTD measurements. In this video, we cover another example where a delta-sigma converter is used in battery monitoring solutions. The objective here is to provide additional case study examples. The general techniques covered in these case studies can be adapted to many different topologies. This slide shows the block diagram for the general battery monitoring system that we need to protect. In summary, this circuit measures the current and voltage across the battery using an instrumentation amplifier and an op-amp. The goal of this presentation is to design the protection circuit represented as a box at the input of the ADS131MO8 analog-to-digital converter. Here are the absolute maximum ratings and recommended operating conditions of the ADS131MO8. Notice that this device has somewhat unusual ESD input protection. It uses a single diode to AVDD, but does not have a diode to ground. The reason the negative supply does not have a diode is that the input can actually go 1.3 volts below ground. A traditional diode clamp would not allow for this range. The device does have an ESD structure for negative going ESD pulses, but this structure cannot be used for in-circuit EOS protection. For this device, the ability to allow input signals below the negative supply is an important feature which is used in many of its target applications. To protect this circuit, we will need to consider the recommended and absolute maximum analog input range. In this case, the recommended range can measure 1.3 volts below ground, and the absolute maximum cannot be lower than 1.6 volts below ground. Ideally, we would build an input clamp that will turn on between minus 1.3 volts and minus 1.6 volts. Let's take a look at one possible solution. Here is the protection circuit for the ADS131MO8. D1 is a traditional positive clamp which will turn on when the input is above 3.3 volts. A Schottky BAT54 was used as it has a low forward voltage and relatively low leakage. T1 is a TVS diode that will absorb transients directed through D1 to the positive supply. Keep in mind that the LDO that is supplying the 3.3 volts cannot sink large transient currents. D2 and D3 are placed in series to create a clamp that typically drops 0.9 volts. Thus, this will allow the input voltage to swing about 0.9 volts below ground before turning on. On the previous slide, we saw that the recommended input range should allow for signals to go 1.3 volts below ground, so it seems that it would be better to choose a device with a higher forward drop. But we will see in the next few slides that it is very difficult to find a diode that will remain fully off inside the normal operating range but will turn on before the absolute maximum voltage. Recall from the first slide that the ADC inputs are driven by two different amplifiers, the INA821 and the TLV171. The output range of the amplifiers corresponds to the worst-case fault signals that the ADC will see. For both amplifiers, the output voltage range is from minus 5 volts to plus 10 volts, and the maximum output currents are at most 35 milliamps. The amplifier specification short circuit current is always the maximum output current that an amplifier can supply. These currents and voltage ranges will be used in the next few slides to select the resistor values for R1 and R2. Note that under normal operation, all the diodes are reverse biased. For positive EOS, D1 will turn on and direct the EOS event to T1. For negative EOS events, D2 and D3 will turn on and limit the input voltage to about minus 0.9 volts. In this slide, we will select a value for R1 for positive EOS events. Before finding R1, we collect all the important overstress parameters. First, we determine the worst-case fault currents that R1 will see. These currents are taken from the amplifier short circuit current specifications. Next, we consider the worst-case voltages that will be applied in an EOS condition. In this case, it is the amplifier maximum output range. Finally, we get the absolute maximum ADC input specifications. To find the value for R1, we need an accurate diode voltage drop. The drop depends on the current flow in the diode. The curves for the BAT54 are used with the maximum current to determine the maximum diode drop of 0.4 volts. The voltage across R1 is calculated by subtracting the diode and supply voltage from the input fault voltage. The resistor voltage is then divided by the fault current to find a minimum value for the series limiting resistor. Increasing this resistor will make the circuit more robust, but will add noise and increase leakage current errors. Here we perform the same calculation as in the previous slide, but for negative EOS events. For a negative fault, the diodes D2 and D3 will turn on. This procedure yields a slightly different minimum value for R1. For the positive fault, R1 was 252 ohms, and for the negative fault, the resistor is 850 ohms. Choose the largest of the two resistors and round up for margin. In this case, we selected 1 kiloohms for the limiting resistor. The last step is to select a value for R2. This resistor limits the input current to the ADC to plus or minus 1 milliamp. A similar calculation is used for R2, and the value is determined to be 100 ohms. This slide shows the measured results for the diode clamp circuit. The circuit works well for protection, as the clamp limits the input voltage to less than the absolute maximum rating for the ADC. On the other hand, recall that the operating range of the ADC extends to minus 1.3 volts. This circuit will begin to turn on at approximately minus 0.9 volts, so some error will be introduced below the minus 0.9 volt input signal. Here we test the input protection to show that the input diodes have minimal impact on performance. Test 1 illustrates performance with the protection diodes, and test 2 illustrates performance without the diodes. You can see that some distortion is introduced by the diodes, but it is minimal. Finally, this slide shows the results of a DC linearity sweep. The circuit has some inherent gain error, but when an endpoint calibration is performed, the overall error is very low as a percentage. Note that the input range is limited to about minus 1.14 volts, as driving the input signal lower will begin to turn on the external protection diodes D2 and D3. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. Question 1. For the circuit below, why is a series diode circuit used to protect against negative faults? The correct answer is B, to allow a small negative voltage swing below ground. This particular ADC allows input swings below ground, so it does not have a traditional internal ESD diode.